prayers for you. But today my music podcast about the talk. I for somebody who at a very young age first started hearing and listened to Metallica. You know, at that time, I was a newbie, first hearing music, I mean, at a young age, but hearing Metallica, I mean, I was like, holy shiz, I did not know who the band Metallica was until I did research the band's history from when they started back to when Master of Puppets, their first set of mini albums came out. Well, Master of Puppets was the one album that Cliff Burton, late great Cliff Burton, was with Metallica years before he passed away at that horrific bus crash that really put Metallica's career kind of on hold until Jason Newsted. If you guys all seen the whole interview I got in the documentary that was about Metallica's career, like how the band was formed and everything that the band went through. Cliff Burton passed away, the horrible bus crash. Jason Newsted, the lifelong Metallica fan, steps in, and he has been with Metallica in sort of enough. He was frustrated with Metallica because he was working on this big, and he was working on this Echo Brand record that really got numbers of members of Metallica kind of flustered and not pleased that Jason Newsted was working on this Echo Brand record that he should be doing with Metallica, and then Jason Newsted kind of was let go by Metallica. And then at that point, Metallica's career kind of was eager to go. It's like a little cliche, the Lars Ulrich said in the piece of Interview Icon of Metallica. You guys should definitely go check out Lars Ulrich said the best to keep this Metallica train rolling on the tracks. On the tracks. There was a point in Metallica's long story, decade history that when Jason Newsted left, it was kind of like the rest of the members of Metallica, they did not know what they were going to do next. James Hetfield thought he had some demons, problems that was going on with him, his drinking habits. That kind of got almost got the best of him. He had to step away. Part of this was a long time ago. But James Hetfield, now today, is fully recovered. He got his life normal. Now this was like many years, long after they were inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Cliff Burton's passing. I mean, if you look at Metallica, you go really back to Master of Puppets album that really put the band on a collision course to really become today a successful hard rock heavy metal gods today. But if you think of, Master of Puppets was really one of their big albums that really put Metallica over the top, and especially Ride the Lightning. I mean, I remember the day when Ride the Lightning first came out, I was just like, holy was head over heels pursuing Fade to Black. And Jason Newsted said into the icon saying when they were playing Fade to Black in the concert, Jason Newsted said best that when they were playing Fade to Black, and it was kind of like my swan song, and that was when Jason Newsted was kind of like career with Miss Metallica was kind of beginning to go smoothly because of the whole Echoing record deal, and he said there was some members of Metallica that maybe we should take a year off and kind of like step away, and everybody else was just like, well, we can't do it, we're going to record. And Jason Newsted was saying, well, tell me to step off. And, you know. But me, I remember personally with Fade to Black became like Metallica's really big name song. For whom bell tolls. I mean, I can go on and on with about Riding the Lightning. When the Black Album came out, and then some kind of monster DVD. Then they did the collaboration with Lil Wayne for the album Lil. That really kind of put people's perspective on Metallica kind of different. It's kind of like, gee, but what you listen to in the view with Metallica and the movie, you kind of get that feel that when they really did doing their hard rock-ish for the song, and the album was kind of like, but once you listen to the album in the movie, it's basically like a hard rock spoken word, where we were speaking the word, it's kind of like a poet. And then years later, was recently, Metallica was getting up for their next big album, because we were so hopefully for a brand new Metallica album, like something totally brand new, but till they were doing that, they began releasing a new sound that they did live, Lords of Summer, which makes it kind of like, is this going to be just a one-off song that they're going to do? Is it going to be a new album? Until the show online and all that, that Metallica was in the studio putting together the brand new album that totally is going to blow people right out of the water. Became Hallmark Self-Destruct. Until if you go down the line, we're seeing like they have released every single from the album Hardware, Alice the Rise, Off the Flame, Murder of Modern. I was very pleased how well that album became like huge. It was kind of like a mystery that we did not know if Metallica was going to do another album, because, you know, it's in their DNA that they have to keep the ball rolling if they take, like, a year or two off. Because the band, it's, the band Metallica has been busy. They had to do this kind of like, because, you know, the band's been around for